application of elasticity. With the graph, we know the yield point of different material. In the industry, we are using material like ropes, rods, channels on which the total structure is placed, and there is a lot of load, like this roof, this floor has full load on the steel we have used. Suppose that load is more than the yield limit, what will happen? This steel rod will go on under the load, will go on extending, 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 and will break. So we must know how much load we are applying, and that should be within the yield limit. But that is not even good enough, not safe. We make it much, much less, and that we call safety limit. Suppose the yield limit of steel is 100. How much load should we give to that wire? The answer is we should give it load of 10 kilogram, only 10%. Okay, if we increase the limit, we should give it 20%. So for different countries, this limit is different. For different departments, this limit is different. But this limit we can apply only if we have knowledge of elasticity. So the load should be given according to yield limit. Then stress and the load, they have a relation. What is that relation? We know that force, that is load upon area, is stress. So from the chart, if we see the stress, that is modulus, then force is equal to what? Stress multiplied by area. So if our applied force is larger, we should increase the area. Suppose for a steel, the stress value is 200 and we have to apply the force of 1000. What we will do? We will use 5 ropes and put them together, increase the area 5 times. Then the load or the force we can use 5 times. So please remember, for increasing the load, what we should increase? Area. For increasing load, increase area. And what was the first thing? The load must be within the stress. Must be within elastic limit. It should never cross elastic limit, otherwise that wire we are using for lifting the load, the material we are using for carrying the load, will keep on extending, 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 and finally it will break. That is why it is necessary we keep it under the limit. What is that limit? Elastic limit. And if we want to increase the load, increase the area. Take a thicker sheet, take a thicker rod, take a thicker channel. This is what is the knowledge of elasticity tells us, and this is how we design 100 floor building, 150 floor building. Everything they design with the load, with the stress, with the area. And without that design, we cannot create so many marvels. Okay, another example, a very common example in our houses, we are using channels to make the roof, and that takes the load. In the bridges also, we have these two pillars, and on this pillar, we put here one structure. Okay, let us say this is a metal plate, which has got certain thickness, certain width, and certain length between these two. I will make the length just flushing with the ends here. Okay, this. So it has length, it has width, and it has thickness T. When there is a load on this bridge, what will happen? In condition of load, this will become like this. And by the law of geometry, you know this length and this length are different. This length is more than the this length. This is the extension, this much, delta L. This is L. So there, whenever there is a load, here load, what happens with the load? There is a extension. Now, if the load goes on increasing and the extension goes on increasing, what will happen? We know in the graph, if there is a extension beyond a certain limit, what will happen? It will break. Extension, this is strain, you know. So after a certain extension, it is going to break. So after a certain extension, it is going to break, number one. Number two, after a certain extension, after this, it will not come back, even if the load is removed, because this is the elastic limit, yield point. So if there is a lot of load here, and it become like this, and this is more than the yield limit. After that, this load has gone here. Suppose a heavy truck came from here. There was depression, delta depression. After that, the truck has gone on this side, and this does not come back. It remained like this. Why? Because the stress has crossed this limit, beyond elastic limit. So it is necessary that engineer must know the elastic limit, and this delta should be under the control. If this delta is more, then it will enter into the inelastic limit, plastic limit. It must remain within this. So we must control this delta. And for this delta, we have done many calculations and we got a formula, a relation for this delta. This should be small, and this, there is a relation, and that relation tells us that this delta depends upon many factors and power of those factors. This load W, and the formula for delta is W L cube divided by 4 B D to the power 3 and Young's modulus. This is breadth. What I have written W, this is breadth. B, this is breadth, depth, and length. These three things are there. So length, okay. This depth is this. D, what we were calling thickness. This is D, this is breadth, and this is length, and load on this is W, and the depression is delta. We want this depression should be as less as possible. The depression will be given by these quantities. So we just observe what should be more, what should be less. If length is more, that is, we call it span. If this span is very long, span become two times, only two times, the depression become eight times. So we should not increase length between the two walls. Because a small percentage of increase in length will be 3 times multiplied to give the depression. Large. Okay. We want this depression should be as small as possible so that it will return back. That means all these quantity should be large. B should be large. D should be large. Thickness should be large. And Y, this also should be large. So we use a material steel because steel has got maximum Young's modulus. Okay, done. Now this breadth and depth, which is more effective? If I double the breadth 2 times, the delta will decrease 2 times. Decrease 2 times. I want to decrease it. If I increase this D 2 times, 2 times, 2 into 2 into 2, delta will decrease 8 times. So that means this D is very effective. If I make it only 2 times, this delta will decrease 8 times. It will never cross Y limit. That means if I have a certain weight of steel, 100 kg of steel, and I have an option to make it a beam, what should I keep more? Which dimension? The answer is I should keep this depth, this D, as large as possible. D should be as large as possible, right? Compared to B. Now, how can we make the D very large and not using much of steel, because steel costs much? So using less steel but still making D very large. So what do? We make a shape which is like this. And this we call as channel. And this goes long this way. That is this way. Now this is what? D. This is B. And this way it is length. Length is this. This is channel. Now in this you see, we have not used steel here. We have not used steel here. Even if we this comes, suppose a small section of this weighs 5 kg. If I make it like this, it will be 10 kg. Double. But is there any change in D? No change. Any change in B? No change. Then will it affect any delta? No. So if I make it a solid one and if I make this hollow one, there is no difference in the depression. So in place of using so much steel, I use a very small quantity of steel, keeping this D very large so that the depression becomes very small. Right. So this is how we make the bridges with help of channel. And this is, if you put it like this, it will appear as this way. This appears letter I, so we call it I channel. So we are using I channel. This is D, this is B. If we put it this way, then this is D and this is B. In this case, D is very large. So if this is D and very large D, the depression will be less. Now for 100 kg, this depression comes out to be 2 millimeter. We know that the depression is harmless till 6 millimeter. So we can increase, we can allow this load up to 300 kg, 6 millimeter. But if we make it flat like this, this suppose has weight 10 kg. And this is also 10 kg. But you see here D. It is a smaller D, so the depression will be more. So I would like to use this. In place of this, depression is 5 millimeter. In case of this, depression is only 2 millimeter. So if I am using this, I can allow more load to go. So the load carrying capacity increase with this. So this is how the shape differs. So this is the knowledge of elasticity which help us. So with this, we close this chapter of elasticity, and after that we will study the properties of fluids, liquids, that we will do in the next lecture. Thank you.